Thank you for joining us for our reflection on a lesson from the Daily Office Lectionary. My name is Mother Elizabeth Papazoglakis, and I serve as Associate Rector at St. George's Episcopal Church in Clifton Park, New York. Today is Monday in the seventh week after Pentecost. Let us pray. O God, the protector of all who trust in you, without whom nothing is strong, nothing is holy. Increase and multiply upon us your mercy, that with you as our ruler and guide, we may so pass through things temporal, that we lose not the things eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Our lesson is from Paul's letter to the Romans, the 16th chapter, beginning at the first verse. I commend to you our sister Phoebe, a deacon of the church at Cenchrea, so that you may welcome her in the Lord as is fitting for the saints, and help her in whatever she may require from you. For she has been a benefactor of many, and of myself as well. Greet Priscilla and Aquila, who work with me in Christ Jesus, and who risk their necks for my life, to whom not only I give thanks, but also the churches of the Gentiles. Greet also the church in their house. Greet my beloved Opinitus, who was the first convert in Asia for Christ. Greet Mary, who has worked very hard among you. Greet Andronicus and Junia, my relatives who were in prison with me. They are prominent among the apostles, and they were in Christ before I was. Greet Ampliatus, my beloved in the Lord. Greet Urbanus, our co-worker in Christ, and my beloved Stachys. Greet Apelles, who is approved in Christ. Greet also those who belong to the family of Aristobulus. Greet my relative Herodian. Greet those in the Lord who belong to the family of Narcissus. Greet those workers in the Lord Tryphena and Tryphosa. Greet the beloved Perses, who has worked hard in the Lord. Greet Rufus, chosen in the Lord, and greet his mother, a mother to me also. Greet Asyncritus, Phlegon, Hermes, Patrobus, Hermas, and the brothers and sisters who are with them. Greet Philologus, Julia, Nerus, and his sister Olympus, and all the saints who are with them. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the churches of Christ greet you. Here ends the lesson. Paul's introduction at the beginning of this lesson is the longest introduction of all of Paul's letters. In the letters that Paul has written to churches that he himself founded, he rarely greets individuals as he does here. That may have been because he did not single out some individuals and neglect others. In any case, the difference that one notes now undoubtedly comes from the fact that this letter is being sent to Rome, to a congregation that he did not found personally, but in which he knows that a number of Christian friends now reside. We learn two things about Phoebe from this letter. She is referred to as diakonos, or servant, which means that she is a woman of stature in the church, and she is also a benefactor. Paul is introducing Phoebe to the community as she is one who is bringing Paul's letter. Paul is letting the community know who she is. Phoebe is likely carrying Paul's letter as a favor while on her own business trip. She is described as a benefactor, a patron, and Paul says of many and himself. Paul's introduction of Phoebe lets us know that women occupied leadership roles in the early Christian communities. It should not go unnoticed that the document that has been judged as one of the most influential documents in Christian history was entrusted to this woman, on the long and risky journey to its destination. Our lesson closes with Paul saying, "Greet one another with a holy kiss." Paul assumes that the customary holy kiss in the communities that he founded is also practiced in the community in Rome. Let us pray. Most loving Father, whose will it is for us to give thanks for all things, to fear nothing but the loss of you, and to cast all our care on you who care for us, preserve us from faithless fears and worldly anxieties, that no clouds of this mortal life may hide from us the light of that love which is immortal, and which you have manifested to us in your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Thank you for joining us. Join us every weekday for our reflection. If you live in the Clifton Park area, join us for worship at 4:30 on Saturdays or 8 o'clock or 9:30 on Sunday mornings. If you're unable to join us in person, join us virtually through our YouTube channel. Our webpage provides recordings and details about all of our offerings.